My name is Gina Csanyi-Robah. I'm the current executive director at the Toronto Roma Community Centre, the only organization existing in Canada representing the needs and helping the Roma community specifically. The Roma Community Centre is a 100% volunteer-based organization, which opened in 1997, became a nonprofit in 1998, was housed inside a very large immigration settlement organization called CultureLink up until October 2011. This past October 2011, we were finally able to build enough capacity to open our own independent office. At our office, we help now with daily settlement service needs, with education, and also with building pride in Roma culture. Come with you today. I'm immensely appreciative of this important opportunity. As far as I know, I'm the first Roma person in Canada to have this privilege of coming and presenting in front of our Canadian government. I was born in Canada. My family came here in 1956 as Roma refugees from Hungary during that revolution, and I've been in Canada ever since. I'm a teacher by profession for the Toronto District School Board, and I use my other time to be the executive director of this organization, so I'm currently working 80 to 90 hours a week to be able to help this community. I come to you today with my testimony and to do my best to encourage this committee to not create a designated safe country list, whereby citizens that are Roma from EU countries will be given an unfair opportunity to seek safety in Canada, while inadvertently condoning the lack of implementation of human rights legislation for Roma minorities in many Central and Eastern European countries. I want to open with a small passage from a February 2012 publication from the Council of Europe. This is the Council of Europe Commissioner for Human Rights, Mr. Thomas Hammerberg. He says, to be able to understand the Roma people, you must have some understanding of their history. The history of European repression against Roma precedes the Nazi and fascist era, where Roma lost 2 million of their own during the Holocaust. In fact, it goes back several hundred years, following the Roma migration from the Indian subcontinent from the Rajasthan area in the 10th century. The Roma were the outsiders, used as scapegoats when things went wrong, and the locals did not want to take responsibility. The methods of repression have varied over time and have included enslavement, enforced assimilation, expulsion, internment, mass killings, genocide. This is the history of the Roma people in Europe. Nothing has changed since the 13th century when we've been in the since we arrived in the European continent. It's not a pretty history. Roma are coming, leaving apartheid-like conditions in education, housing, health care, every segment and sector of society you can imagine. Hate is organized, it's endemic, it's been ongoing for a long time. It's nothing new. When I meet with members of the Hungarian government who've come to the Roma Community Center, they sit there and think I'm speaking some alien language when I tell them about the hate that's crippling our community. The only answer I've ever been given by Zoltán Balog, the Minister of Social Inclusion, Susanna Repas, Attila Kocsi, and the Hungarian Ambassador to Canada, is that there's an economic problem taking place. This is a lie. What's also a lie is that Roma are bogus refugees. In 2011, there was 167 accepted applications at the Immigration Refugee Board. That means that if Roma are bogus, that those Immigration Refugee Board adjudicators are liars. And I don't think that they are. I don't think that they should be fired. And it makes absolutely no sense to call Roma refugee claims bogus if even one refugee claim is accepted. Roma are not living off the welfare system. They're coming to the Roma Community Center every single day, begging us to help them find jobs. We've created a Friday resume writing clinic. We have Roma that have come here that are now in school. They're going to college. They're working. They're trying their best to be as empowered and have a voice as possible. They have a large number of withdrawn refugee claims because it's been an incredibly unwelcoming climate for Roma people in Canada. In 2009, there was an 85% acceptance rate for a Czech Roma Roma refugees before the visa was reimposed and public discourse started talking about bogus refugee claims.
Thank you for the opportunity to address the committee today. I'm speaking as a representative of the Roma Community Center, but I'm a lawyer in private practice since 1988. I'm also a former member of the Immigration and Refugee Board, where I sat as a member for 5 years. I currently represent many Roma refugees. I'll focus on Roma refugees from Hungary because these refugees seem to be of particular concern. I would like to begin by addressing a question. Hungary is an EU country, so why don't the Roma relocate to another EU country? There are misconceptions about this issue, and in fact, there are serious barriers to relocation. The first barrier is that EU citizens cannot make asylum claims in EU countries. Therefore, Roma from Hungary cannot, for example, file refugee claims in Italy. Secondly, there's a limitation on the right to relocate within the EU. A person can stay in a country for up to 3 months and then must either find a job or show enough money to support themselves. Owing to the high level of prejudice against Roma in the EU, finding a job is extremely difficult. When France deported Roma en masse in the summer of 2010, this sent a clear message that Roma cannot simply relocate within Europe. What is the Refugee Board doing with these claims? The United Nations stated that the Roma community faces discrimination in all fields of life, and further, they face violence by extremists and prejudice by the police. They arrive in Canada missing teeth because neo-Nazis have kicked them out and with visible scars from being attacked by fascists. They are no different from refugees who come from Africa or Asia. The board knows this. It accepts that hate crimes exist, but refuses the claims on a technical point of law. The federal court has in fact begun setting aside some of these decisions, saying that the board has made mistakes. Turning to the DCO list, there are concerns. The criteria for the DCO operates regardless of whether the country is safe. It uses statistics of rejected, withdrawn, and abandoned cases to determine whether a country is designated instead of human rights records. This statistical analysis appears to be directed at Roma claims. We hear a lot about the high number of refused Hungarian Roma cases. Of the cases that actually came before the Refugee Board in 2011, just under 1 in 5 were accepted as refugees. In other words, the claimants who appeared before a board member, just under 1 in 5 were determined to be refugees. The overall acceptance rate of the board is about 39%. This is very important to consider. We've also been hearing a lot about Roma criminals. This is a tiny drop in the bucket. And in Canada, we are surely above racial stereotyping. The minister expressed concerns that claimants from EU countries don't need Canada's protection because they are bogus. People who work with Roma refugees are at a loss to figure out why this group is called bogus. Why has the minister not expressed concern about growing fascism and racism instead of condemning Roma refugees? The Prime Minister expressed support to fight anti-Semitism and racism recently on Holocaust Remembrance Day. We support this. The extremist party in Hungary with 20% of the vote is anti-Roma and also blatantly anti-Semitic and has even forged an alliance with Iran. Anti-Semitism in Hungary is rampant. We should condemn the human rights abuses in Hungary for both the Jews and the Roma. And the situation in Hungary is worsening. A new constitution took effect in January. The changes in the constitution reflect a move away from democratic principles, and the EU has actually begun legal action against Hungary because it is no longer a true democracy. So how can we call the Roma claims bogus? Why was the DCO list created to discourage Roma claims? Are the Roma claims proving to be a problem in light of free trade negotiations with Europe? I urge you to consider the fact that refugee determination is a human rights issue, that we have an obligation to protect persecuted people, and that this must not be trumped by political factors. Thank you.